SQL console. And what are the commands we have used? The calculation one we done, then we have created the database also, right? If you haven't the database, you can quickly create the database. Right, go to the MySQL prompt and write the command create database, name of the database. Can you see the PowerPoint presentation?
Yes, madam.
Yeah. Then you can create the database name search. Already if you have created, no need. If not, if there is, you can check whether this database is available. Right? Go to the command prompt and see show databases. Show databases, then you can see the, what are the available databases in your machine. If not, write the command create database search. Right? Then to use the database search, you want to write the command use search and with a semicolon. Right? Under this database, we are going to create the tables. Right? Again, to see the available tables, show tables, no need to, if you haven't created the table, no need to write this command. Then straight away you can create the table. Right? To create the table, the database search, you want to write the command use search. Use search command. Then you are inside the database search. Right? Then the table name of this under the database, we are thinking of table name is employee. Then to create the table, how to create the table? Command create table, name of the table. Then you want to write the fields, separate fields with the data type. Right? First name, what are the fields we have? First name, last name, city, sex, and date of birth. Then first name, last name, and city, the data type we use VACHA, right? This is the characters, maximum characters you can type with this field, right? Then sex also one character, that is CHA with the one character, we can write only the male or female, M or F, right? Then next, last column, that is date of birth, data type is date. And we have discussed what are the available data types under MySQL. Then if there are any errors occur when you write the commands, you can retype it with the correct one. Right? No need to type again. You can use the up and or down arrow key to get the previous command. Right? The previous type command, you can use up and down keys. Now you are typing with me, right? Are you typing the commands?
Yes, madam.
Or not yet?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Then have you finished the creating table one?
No, madam. Not yet.
Madam, I have a question.
Yeah.
How do we start the MySQL in command prompt?
We have now, you do you have the VAM server?
I having exam.
You check whether it doesn't have this MySQL. Now in the VAM server, we have that, right? VAM also you should have. Go to the top up menu and see. Here we have the MySQL console. If you don't have quickly, you can. Do you have the VAM server with you? You can.
Yes, madam. I have.
Yeah.
But in my SAM control panel, it shows a shell, and I don't know how to open the MySQL.
There's no menu called MySQL. You can't appear there.
There is a MySQL menu.
Yeah.
But from the menu, I can't open the command prompt. It shows only start and stop.
It goes.
Have you Minshal? Have you in panel admin button there or no?
Control panel.
No. In SAM control panel, in MySQL, have you admin button and stop and start button near to the admin button?
Yeah.
Click here. And you any password? Want?
Password. If you haven't given password, just you can press the enter key and go.
There are no password for you. Come open and the admin panel again.
What about last week also? You are not working with that MySQL part.
Last week I didn't attend lectures, madam.
Right. What about others? Everyone has the VAM server.
Okay.
Try with that. Now okay or not yet? If not, what you can do? You can uninstall.
Yes, it's okay, madam. I will try.
Okay now. You don't have the. Still, you didn't get that?
No, madam.
No.
No problem. There is a console.
Yeah.
Right. But it's in the web browser. I will try.
Open in web browser. And you can see in web browser if there are.
It's working with the browser.
Yes. And
no problem. Tell you this.
Yes, can't you type the commands then?
Yes, I can type, madam, now.
Okay then. Okay.
Yeah.
And we will go ahead. Right,
okay,
then, quickly, you can create the database. Right, and create the use database to create the employee table. And once you create the table with the five fields, you can see how it looks like with the using describe command. Describe and name of the table, describe employee semicolon. Then you can see the table like this, right? Field names and the data types. We haven't created the primary key and anything we haven't created. So just those columns are empty. Otherwise, the fields and the types are available. Right, says that we have five rows in the set. Right, everyone got this structure of your table. This is the structure of your table. I think most probably first week of September we'll start the physically university will start right
September 1
sorry
September 1
yeah yeah September 1st week we'll start the definite the exact date we'll inform late so actually I have to do another one or two sessions to complete the MySQL I will hand over to the Dr. Anthunga who is doing the second part of the web programming and we will meet on the physically also we can do the one or two sessions if needed we can do once we start the university
amen
okay
madam
right then next one we are going to enter the data to the table right to enter the load the data into the table how you can write the data insert into name of the table insert into employee values then within bracket you can type the all the data right one by one first we have given the first name last name then city sex and the date of birth each field you can type within the single quote separated by comma right the end of the statement normally we write the semicolon and this is only one record right inserting for your employee table
kubana insert into employee name also for
the sex we can type only single character because we put only the character data type as char if you want to write the entire name male like the female you want to change the data type right then you can change the vacha data type to display the entire text here already we have defined cha then you can type only the single character and when you write the date of birth then starting from the year 4 digits character year month and date
name last name extended name last name city sex date of birth निमल सिल्वर अपना प्रोग्राम
चेंज एंड इफ वन लाइन इज कंप्लीटेड देन यू कैन चेक यू कैन सी whether those information has gone to your table to see that right to retrieve the information from a table you can type the command is the common statement general form select what to select from which table we are condition to satisfy right select what is the command you have to type select what to select if you want to select particular row you can type it otherwise if you want to say or entire table you can write the select star mean all from which table from employee table right if you want to write the later on you can type the via condition also if you want the people who came from the Colombo likewise you can change the this retrieve the information from the table you can select the your requirement right then to select all the records from your table select all from employee table we have one row with the data.
Madam, is in this insert into employee values query, it is some missing double quotation in Ratnapura.
Yeah, you can make it correct. Right in my the slide here, yeah, there is a mistake. Never mind, you can type okay. The single quote. Okay.
Okay.
To identify the error. Right now, do you have the one report?
Yes, madam.
Everyone?
Report. Okay, madam.
Yeah, then you can add more rows to the same table, right? At least 5 rows. Again, you can get the same command by pressing the arrow key, up or down arrow key, right? And change the names, right? First name, last name, what you have, you can change it, right? The command is same, insert into employee values. Then instead of Nimal, different name, right? Then surname, town, city, and sex, state of birth. Different records you can include at least 5 records. Right? Okay.
Okay, madam.
Right. Then again, you can see how many records are available. Right. Select all from employee. Right. To see all the records are in your table. And don't type the next command, that is to drop the database. Right? Then go to the next slide. Right, next one, to select the particular row, right, if you want to select not the entire table, to select the one record, then you can type the select all from employee table where clause you can use here, where if name equal to, you can write the name which you have typed, right, then commas. Now here I have get the commas record and select what to select. We select from the all the records from employee table where first name equal to comma, right? You need to get the last name equal to Silva or something, then you can write the last name equal to Silva. If there are two names, then it will appear the both. Select all from employee where if name equal to, it is single quote, write the name. Right, then next one, update a record. To update the record, now once you complete your table, if you want to change some data, you can do that. To update the record, And now here we are changing city instead of goal. We type it different name, Deival, right? How to do that? Update table name, right? Set city equal the new one which you are going to change, right? That is new name. Where what is the record? F name equal to comma, right? Then you want to specify the record, which record you are going to change, and what is this changing name, right? Instead of goal, we change the label. So you can change the update employee table, set city equal name of the city you intend to change, which record we are first name equal to comma.
Name common.
You can get the previous type command, select all from the table, right? Select all from table employee, right? And see whether this changes has made. Because already we have changed the name of the city, it should be changed and update to your record. In your table, it should be updated. The next command. Right, if you want to get all the date of birth, right? Rather than some the year date and month, you can see all the records from your table. The whose date of birth more than this date, right? Then how to write this command? Select all from employee table where date of birth greater than the year, right? You can check your table, see the table, and write the date, right? At least two or three records to be displayed. You can write, give the year, date of birth, year date, and the month and date. Then you can appear the select all the those who was born before this, after this day. And using where clause, you can do this select type any records from your existing table. Right, then next one, you can use some condition also. You can combine some conditions using AND command. Right, not only the date of birth, if you want to display the who are the males of the who born in this year, then you can write the AND command also. Right, select all from employee table where date of birth greater than this date and sex equal M. That means you can combine the two conditions. One is the people who are male, and another one the date of birth greater than this name. Using AND command, you can do that. Thank you.
Okay, madam.
Okay, right. Then another logical operator, you can use the and not also you can use the to display the records, right? The last name, either Pereira or Silva. I don't know what you have typed for these names. Last name, you can if you want. Now you know how to change the data also. If you don't have the similar name, surnames, last names, then you can change some of the names, right? And display the all the records whose last name is Pereira or last name equal Silva. Then if you have the surname Pereira and last name Silva, all the records should be displayed. Like what are the last names you have given? You can write type those names as last names, and then appear the records with the given last names. And the next one. To select only the particular columns from your table, you can write the given column names or field names by selecting. How to write the command? Select first name, comma, date of birth. If you want to display only the few fields, right, not the entire table. You need only the first name and last name, either first name and the six. Then you can select by writing the select command, select field name, first name, comma, date of birth from which table? From employee table. Then you can appear only the given columns. And sometimes some names can be repeated. The first name can be repeated. Either second, the last name also can be repeated. So if you want to get the what are the available say first names in your record, right? Then Kamal Kamal. If you have the two commas, then it will display two commas, right? To avoid that, you can write the command distinct. Then only the available first names, either last names, will be appear, right? Then only one time it will appear. Not if there are more than one time even. Once you write the distinct command, it will appear only once, right? How to write it? You can see if you have the same names twice. Otherwise, if you can't see that, select distinct first name from employee. So then you can see the only minimize the output, right? No need to type the same name again and again. No need to display. If you need only the what are the available first names, then it will see the only the not the number of rows, it is abstract from the table and display the existing first names. Mm-hmm. the next command. These are the columns we are going to select. Select first name and the sex from the employee table. Yeah, we no need to get all the cities or all the all the cities from your table. We need only the given particular city only. Then you can write what are the cities you need. You can write the where city equal Colombo or city equal goal. You can write according to your table. You can type these commands, right? Then those who came from the Colombo or goal, you can appear the first name and the sex of those students or employees, right? City either Colombo or goal, not only these two cities. We no need to get the other people who came from the other cities. Here we use the where clause and the or logical operator. And then next command, select all from employee table, order by date of birth. Right, it will order. By date of birth. And now you can see the table, ordered table with the date of birth. Right, then next command, now you have the how many columns do you have now? We have five columns and five rows in your table. Say you want to add new column to your table. We will see how to do that. If you want to add one more column, and then we are going to change the table. That's why we write the command alter table, name of the table. Then add the column. Right, this is the name of your column. Add email, and you want to write the data type as well, right? Data type and the size, because this is the data type of the email address. We can enter the maximum 20. If you write within bracket 20 characters, that means you can type the up to 20 characters in your field email, right? Then it will add the column to be to the last, right? Once you write the just alter table employee, add email or whatever the field you want, you can type here with the data type, then it will add to the last column of your table. Then we need not at the column to be last. It will be somewhere between some fields. Then you can specify that using second command, alter table employee, add age and data type after command, after city, right? You want to add the age column after city column, then you can specify that using after the name of the field. Even for the last column also you can add that one also before the now this the last column is the say date of birth. If you want to add the another column for the after the date of birth, you can do the in the same way, right? But if you want to add the column to be first in your table, you can write the command, same command here. At the end, write the first, right? Alter table employee, add whatever the field names, you can write with the size first. First mean it will add to the first column of your table. Right, now we can add any place of your table, any place, new column, right? You can add even as a last column or somewhere around the between columns, either as a first column of your table, right? If you want to add the as a first column, then you can write the first at the end of your command. Otherwise, after the write the which column you need, after which column. You can write in that way. Okay, we will delete the sub columns also. If you have created these columns, you can display the entire table now, right? Select all from employee. To delete the column, you can write the alter table employee drop email. That means it will delete the employee email column. Right? Alter table employee drop email. Right? The name of the column you can type. Right, after the typing this command, you can see again how is the new table. Now you know how to delete the column using the drop command, alter table employee drop email, right? Then how to delete the particular row, delete the row from your table, delete from employee table. Now we are not writing delete command for the columns, we change the alter table, right? Here to delete the table row, you write the delete from employee table where and specify the last name or first name. You can write the first name equal to Ajit, right? Then we ask the record you have in given name, it will delete it. Delete from employee table where first name equal to within single quote write the which record you want to delete with the first name. If there are two names, you can then you can write the last name or first name equal this one and last name equal this one. The particular the entire command you can write to delete the entire row.
Okay, madam.
Okay. Okay, then next command we are calculating the age of the employee by using the this command, right? How to find the, now if you have the date of birth, using current date you can find the age, right? Then how to write this command? It will add the new column and calculate the age, right? Select, carefully you want to type this command, select first name, last name, comma, current date, comma. Then you can, if you want, you can just press the enter key and write the next command within bracket, year in capital letters, year within bracket, current date, open and close brace. Again, year, date of birth. Now check whether your in a table date of birth should appear in the simple letters. If you write in the capital letters, you want to write the way you have written in your table. Right? Year is the field name of the date of birth. Right? Then again, two places. One, this is close bracket, and this is for the year. Before the year, we open the bracket. It should be close here. As age from employee table. Right? There is nothing here, just as age from employee table. Then type the semicolon at the end of your command. Then only, why we write the select F name, L name and current date? Because you can abstract from your table first name, last name and current date also, it should be appear another column, and age column also displayed, right? We are not getting the sex and what are the other fields, city, no need, right? If you want to get only the first name and last name and current date and age, right? You can abstract from the existing table. That's why we write the select first name and last name. Calculation of the age, you write the command with the current date minus year date of birth. Will be appear the new column for age. We put here as age. That means you have the new column age. Calculated age also should be displayed there.
Okay, madam.
You got the age? Right. And how many columns do you have in your table now?
Have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128,
But once you write this command, you can you abstract the first name, last name, and the current date and the age.
Sorry. Four columns. No. 1, 2, 3. Four columns.
Four columns. First yes. name, last name. Then current date is there.
And the age column.
And age. The age calculated age is there.
Yes, madam.
Okay.
No, madam, no. It says no, madam. Because I have that data is incorrect because my lot of data.
Yeah, it should be the age should be calculated and it should be displayed in your table in age column. Anyone got the age? You want to write the command correctly, otherwise it won't come.
I have three calculation, bro, madam. One is 40, two otherwise 20 and 18, because
okay, okay. However, you know that you can just manually also calculate, right? Okay, then it should be added the new column age and display the value, right?
Okay, madam.
Right, then next command, those who haven't get that result, you can retype it again, right? Then next column, say from your date of birth, if you want to abstract only the month, either date or year, you can do that, right? Now select first name and date of birth, and whatever the columns you require, you can write the field names. Select first name, last name, whatever the fields you need, you can write here. Select first name and date of birth, comma, we need month, only month from the date of birth. Right, month within bracket, write the date of birth from employee table. Right, then you can select the month only, right? First name, date of birth, then another column, month from the entire table. Then from your employees in your organization or in your working place, then to see who, those who born in the month of October, then you can write the command, select whatever the field you require, you can write it, select first name, date of birth, so last name, city, either select all from employee table, where month, within bracket you can write the date of birth, right, equal to 10, month equal to 10, why? 10 is October, so you can write the which month you need to see the those who were born in the particular month. You can write the month from where, from which column you write within the bracket. From that is from the date of birth column, you want to write it, and equal to write the month which month you need. You can write the month. It will display the people who are born in month of October or whatever the month you need, you can display that, those information. Okay, you got the answer?
Yes, madam.
Right, right. This is the end of the first presentation. I have sent this one. Do you have this presentation with you?
Yes, madam.
Yes, madam.
Okay. Then we'll go to the next presentation, that is the second one. Sex and date of birth. If you want to change the headings of your table, right, you can write the command. This is the common command for this alter table headings. Alter table. Table name, change the column, right? Change column, then old common column name, new column name, and the data type and the size, right? How to do that now? Instead of city, we are going to change town, right? Okay. In some days, you won't, already you have given the column names. To change the column name, you can write the alter table, name of the table, change column, instead of city, write the town, and data type, it's necessary to type the data type and the size. Data type vacha with the size of 20 and with the semicolon. Right, once you change the name of the city, name of the column. Again, you can see, you see select command, select or from employee table and see whether this changes has made. Okay, have you changed the column name? Right, next one to add the new column, right? New column. Now you know how to add the column to the existing table, either at the beginning of the table, either somewhere in between, or end of the table, right? You can do that. Then to add the column, you can write the command alter table employee add salary or whatever the column name. And the data type, you won't write the data type, right? Then once you add the new column, you can add the data also, right? To add the data, to update employee table, set salary. Now one by one you want to add the this data to the existing table. You can see the first names, either last names, and update the salary. Update the employee table, set salary equal, you can type that, the amount. Where first name equal like it, then those, if you have only the one name, first name as this name, then you can do that, otherwise you won't write the last name, right? The last name, right? Likewise, you can add the, you can fill the entire column. If you have added the new column for your existing table, once you add the column heading with the data type, after that you can add the data also to new column, to the new column, right? When you write the data, then you want to write the update the employee table, set, and write the name of the newly added column equal and the data. You see where close you can add. Where first name equal this one, either last name equal this one. Right, then other now we, you know how to create the table, then how to see the entire data in your table, right? Then how to add the new row, how to add the new column, and to change the existing data, to change the table heading, right? And add the data to the new added column. Then the number of the characters, to display the number of characters in a particular field, right? Then the those who have starting the first name with the given character. And these are summarize things what we have done so far. Then other than that, then the mathematical functions also it's involved with this MySQL, right? To count the number of rows in your table, to find the minimum value, maximum value, and sum value. You can do that also, right? To count the number of total number of employees in your table, you can write the command select count within bracket star, that means all from employee table. And then you can display the number. Yeah, at what time do you have the today's? No, this is my session, right? Tuesday morning you have the my session at 9, in the timetable, right? Then you are free on that slot. Afternoon, do you have the session?
I didn't get that, madam.
Afternoon, do you have the session?
In the afternoon, we have data structures and algorithms.
Ah, okay, okay. Miss Nambosam is doing. Who is doing the lecture?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Right. Then select count command. Select count from employee table. You should go and get the result as number. Then the next command, group by command, will create the groups, right? If you want to see the number of cities in your table, right, you can write the count command from employee table. Group by, you can specify the fields, right? If you want to display the, now we know if you have already filled the entire table, then there should be the number of rows and the cities also similar. If not, you can see the using group by command. You can write the see the number of cities available in your table. But select city, either select six from your table, group by six either city. Then combine of these one, number of employees, combination of city and sex. You can write the select city, comma, sex. Count those numbers from employee group by city and sex, right? You can appear the count the number of records using the select city and the sex. How many records you have in the table, number of cities and the six, right here. Now you can see if you have the same name with the city, right? If we have the same city twice, then you can see the record here, number is 2, right? Now then this is the record. Select city, city and six. Count all the records from employee table group by city comma six. Right, city and six. Right, then it will appear the number. Those who came from Kalambu, we have only one. Those who came from the Morotu, there are 2. Now, if you have the salary column, salary field, you can have you filled the salary column? The data you can fill, and then if you have the salary column, then you can find the maximum and minimum value of the salary. Right, how to write the command? Select minimum within bracket. You can write the field name salary from employee table, either maximum or sum to find the sum of the or the salary of the employee. You can write the sum within bracket salary. Likewise, you can write the these mathematical calculation also using the MySQL command. Then other than that, you can use the average, right? Then highest integer values, mode function. There are some few functions you can use with the MySQL. Then at last, these other two commands, between and in, right? If you want to find the, so if you don't have any questions, I can stop for today. Any issues?
No, madam. So universities are going to start on September, right, madam?
Yeah. September. First week of September, right? The exact date we will inform once we the instructions not given yet. The idea is to start the September, but I'm not sure whether all are coming for the university or final years only. Not yet decided, right? However, we have to continue until they announce. We have to continue the online session. Okay then.
Okay, thank you very much, madam.
Okay.
Thank you, madam.